Dear student, due to coronavirus, school started online classes for your study. So you can subscribe Golden Flower Palia YouTube channel, like and press the bell icon.
Hello students, welcomes you all today in chapter number 1, class 10th economic section. Children, class 10th economic section, chapter number 1 is a development. Development is a word, very familiar word for you, that development is the process in which something grows, becomes more mature in advance. Means it is defined as growth. Some of the important goals are seeking one or more income, equal treatment, freedom, security, respect from others, etc. In the development area or development section, we want all the equality from all the sides. In the second way, you can say different peoples have different development goals. What may be development for one may not, but for the others have even the disrespect for the others. So when we are going to discuss about the development, my dear students, here we will just have the discussion about the principles. So the first principle is here, different people have different development goals. Like we are taking here the example of the farmer. If the farmer works in a field, like the landless farmer works in a field, so what will be his goal or what will be his dream? He want to have his own land or he want to have his own field. In the same manner, we are here having the second point, that is what may be development for one may not for be the others. When we are going to talk about the person or we are talking about the any kind of the area where the work is going to be done, supposed to be for the benefit. So what is the development may be for the one or may be for the others, like in any kind of the state. If any kind of the state there is work is going to be on the process, so what is there? Like we are having the dam building. So in the dam building, what will be a profit? Profit for the state or profit for the other state peoples where the water goes or any kind of the work is going on. But the main peoples, those who are living on the same place, they have to leave the place. So that is not known or not you can say a development for that person. Third point is here, people look at a mix for goal rather than one. Example is here, we are just having a job choosing. We are having a job choosing. So what is going on the job choosing? Like a teacher is working. If the teacher is working for any kind of the institution, so what is the main thing, main motto or main you can say attraction for? Salary is not sufficient for that. Beside the salary, the person is having a working hour, respective areas, respective scenario. After that, the CLs, what he is or she is getting over there. So many points are there. So then in this way, you can say the job selection or job choosing is also a main point. Children, after this, we are here about the average income. What is the average income? It is earned per person in a given area. When any person is just getting any kind of the income, that is earned by the per person into the given area. And after that, we can discuss about the per capita income. Also is just known as what the person is getting on the same area. After that, standard of living of a people in a country depends on their per capita income. As per the people used to live in any kind of the country and what is their lifestyle or living style is there. So as per their per capita income depends on the same thing. The fourth one point is here that the countries with higher per capita income are considered to be more development than the less per capita income. So in this way, we can say the countries with the higher per capita income, the whatever the countries is there, that is just considered is to be a more development than the less per capita income. If any country's income is just less, then that is they are more development. Then the next point is, it is calculated by the dividing area's total income by its the total population. If any kind of the country is just getting whatever the per capita income is there, that the number of the counting is depend as per the population. So in this way you can say the what are the developmental keys are there. The first thing is there, the development is there. Second thing is there per capita, or the third one is there the national income. So development, I am just repeating again, what is a development? That is a growth of our economy along with the improvement of the quality of a life of the people, like the health, education, or you can say the total whatever the ways are there, the surrounding peoples used to live. The main proverb is their health, education, lifestyle. So many things are there. The second one very important point is there, what is a per capita. So per capita income is the average income that is, you can say, obtained as the ratio between national income and population of the country. And the third one is there, very important point is there, that is a national income. So national income is the money value of final goods and services produced by the country during an accounting year. During an accounting year, that thing is known as a national income. So now we are just going to have to discuss about the Human Development Index. So what is a Human Development Index? Human Development Index, it is a composite index prepared by the United Nations Development Program, that is known as a UNDP. UNDP, through its annual Human Development Report published every year, measure that is a parameter such as that is a longevity of life or a levels of a literacy and per capita income. So here we can just measure all the developments by the countries, and we can just come to know the world countries that are on what rank accordingly and into a very high development countries. So high developed countries, that is the medium developed countries, or the low developed countries. So this kind of the ratio is introduced by, that is just known as a Human Development Index, which is just introduced or prepared by the UNDP. So next one is here, that is our infant mortality rate. Infant mortality rate, here the number of the children's, the number of the children's that die before the age of 1 year as the proportion of 1000 live birth in that particular area, that is known as a infant mortality rate. So next one is here, that is a net attendance ratio. Net attendance ratio is it is a total number of the children's, the age group of 6 to 10, that attending the school as a percentage, the total number of the children in the same age group. That children is known, or that kind of the counting or ratio is known as a net attendance ratio. The next is their body mass index. What is a body mass index? That is known as you can say a full form also used to be asked, BMI. BMI, body mass index. One way to find out as the adults are the undernourished to is to calculate body or mass index divided the weight of a person in a kg. Weight of the person in a kg is known as a BMI, body mass index, by the square of the height in a meters. In this figure is less than 18.5, then the person would be considered undernourished persons. It you can say if this BMI is more than 20, then a person is overweight. If the person is more than 25, then person is a overweight. So last but not least, so next point we are just having here discussion about the sustainable development. So my dear students, sustainable development, it means the development without hampering the environment. It is the process of development that satisfies the present needs without compromising the needs of the future generations. When we are just fulfilling our requirements, we are just you can say doing all the needs, whatever the needs just require as per our aspirations, means we are not disturbing any kind of the requirement for the future generation. So that the development is that satisfied our present needs without compromising the needs for the future generation, that is known as a sustainable development. So once again we are just having the revision about the development is there, the importance of the averages are there, and then we just had a discussion about the development. Per capita income is there, and after that the national income is there, then the human development index is there, that is known by the UNDP, and then the infant mortality rate is there, then the literacy rate is there, and the net attendance ratio is there, and the BMI body mass index, and last but not least is there, that is a sustainable development. So I feel that one by one all the explanations by all the topics you understood this chapter. If any kind of the query, if any kind of the question is there, so you're most welcome. So this was all about the chapter. Rest you people go through by the notes. Thank you.
Do self study at home and stay home, save lives. Thank you very much.